Assalamualaikum, hi my dear students, welcome back to our English class. Today we are going to learn a beautiful poem. The poem name is The Panther. Okay, what is the name? Panther, written by Rainer Maria Rilke. Okay, who has written this poem? Rainer Maria Rilke. What do you mean by panther? Panther means what? Panther is a animal. Okay, so I will first tell the page number 143. All of you take page number 143. It is a beautiful poem. At the same time, it has a deep meaning in this. Okay, so what do you mean by panther? Panther is a animal. It's like cheetah, but not cheetah. The color of the panther is black. Okay, the structure and everything is like cheetah, but the color is black color. In your textbook page number 144, they have given this is the panther, black in color. So if you type this panther in YouTube or in Google, the images will come. Okay, images of panther means it will come. You can see that picture, okay, in Google. So now we are going to see about the author, and then we are going to see the meaning of the poem. Author note: born in Prague, Rainer Maria Rilke, 1875-1926, was a Bohemian Austrian poet widely known for his intense lyrics in German. Rilke's early verse, short stories and plays are characterized by romanticism. His poems show the influence of the German folk song tradition. Most of his works are deeply mystical. He not only tried to represent God in his poetry, but also attempted to transform life into art in his poems. At the same time, Rilke was acutely aware of the deep tragedies of living beings, humans, animals alike, and his expression of their individual agonies is said to be still unsurpassed. This poem was translated from German by Jesse Lehmann. So originally this poem is written in German. It was translated by Jesse Lehmann. Now I am going to read the poem. The pink letters words, we have to find out the meanings, and then I'll tell you the meaning of the whole poem. Okay, his weary glance from passing by the bars. Weary, what is the meaning of weary? Tired. Okay, tired. His weary glance from passing by the bars has grown into a dazed and blackened stare. Dazed means confused. Dazed means confused. Okay, it seems to him there are a thousand bars, and out behind those bars the empty air. The pad of his strong feet, that ceaseless sound. What is the meaning they have given? Ceaseless. Everything in your textbook they have given. Okay, no need to worry about that. Okay, ceaseless. Ceaseless means continuous. Cease means stop. Ceaseless means continuous. Sound of supple tread, graceful steps. Supple tread means graceful steps. Behind the iron bands is like a dance of strength circling around. While in the circle, stunned. Stunned means what is the meaning? Dazed. A great will stands. But there are times the pupils of his eyes delayed. Delayed means widen. The strong limbs stand alert, apart, tense with the flood of visions. Flood of visions means dreams. that arise only to sink and die within his heart. So this is the poem about the panther, the animal. Okay, the panther, it is in the cage. Okay, how the panther feelings, okay, how it is seeing the world outside. So everything was written in the poem. Now we are going to see the meaning of the poem. The poem Panther by Rainer Maria Rilke depicts the picture of a panther locked in a cage. So you have that picture. Can you see that picture? You can understand that. So the panther was inside the cage. Okay, inside the cage of a zoo. Okay, where is the panther? The panther is inside the cage in a zoo. Okay, zoo, you know, a zoo is a place we can see different kinds of animals. The cage has iron bars. So the cage is as iron bars. Okay, and the cage has iron bars, and because of being tired, he cannot see anything. Okay, so the panther inside the cage was walking around the cage. Okay, walking around the cage, inside the cage, and it become very tired. He cannot go out of the cage, isn't it? So it's a very pity thing. It looks as though there are thousands of bars which are confusing its vision. So the panther, the animal, seeing them bar, okay, 1, 2, 3, like that it has. It a few bars only, but to him it like thousands of bars. Okay, the panther was thinking it has thousands of bars. Understand? Bars means it in your textbook, they you can see that iron bars. There is 1, 2 like this. Okay, so the panther was thinking it has thousands of bars.
There is no way to escape from behind the cage. So to the panther,
there is no world behind the cage. When he moves round and round cage frequently, it looks as though he is performing a ritual dance. So what happened? The panther could not do anything in the cage, isn't it? No. So it has a small space only. So inside the cage, it is going in and around. So it looks like a ritual dance. The panther is dancing. Okay, performing a ritual dance. It's look like the panther inside the cage of the zoo has a powerful desire to go out. So inside the cage, the panther was desire means fond of. Okay, he likes to go out of the cage. Okay, because he feels paralyzed and arrested. So the panther was very pity inside the cage. For a continuous period of time, the panther was inside the cage. So he wants to come out of the cage. He wants to come out of the cage, but there is no way to come out of the cage. So the panther was paralyzed and arrested. Okay, arrested. It cannot go out. Constantly he is refusing to be tamed. So he is constantly moving in circles to escape from his present fate. So he wants to escape from the cage. Okay, who? The panther. He wants to escape from the cage, but he could not do anything. So what the panther was doing, he is going circling, moving in circles to escape from his present fate. Okay, to escape from his present fate. He wants to escape from this present situation. So he was moving, circling inside the cage. He became distressed. The panther was become very, very distressed. Though panther is a mighty and strong animal, it seems as if all his powerful desires have vanished. So the panther has a powerful, what is that? It's a mighty and powerful animal. But he could not do anything. Why? Because the panther was inside the cage. He could not do anything. So his desires are vanished. His powerful desires are vanished. Goes away. The tone of the poem. What is the poem was giving the message? What is the message of the poem? The message of the poem, the tone of the poem evokes freedom. Okay, when we are reading the poem, we can understand the panther need freedom, isn't it or not? The panther need freedom. It evokes the freedom. The poem depicts the agony of the panther that has been imprisoned. So we can understand the poem depicts the agony. Okay, anger, agony of the panther that has been imprisoned. The panther was imprisoned. So, we can see the agony of the panther. So, the tone of the poem evokes to let the animal survive in the natural state or habitat. So, the poem, after reading the poem, we can understand, we can release the panther, okay? It evokes the animal to survive in the natural habitat, okay? In the natural habitat. Natural habitat fit moth. What? Usually, animals should be in the, what is that, forest only. Okay, the man or imprisoned the animals. Okay, so the poem evokes to let the animal survive in the natural habitat. A prisoner and the panther in the cage are different in some respect. So here the author is comparing, we can compare the prisoner. Prisoner means person inside the cage. Okay. Prisoner means person. Human beings are in the cage. You have to see the difference between the panther and the human beings. Okay. The prisoner and the panther are different. Why different means prisoner can, what is that, inside the cage, he can get rid of the boredom and he can do something. Prisoner, human beings have sins, but the panther could not do anything. The panther has no sins. He could not do anything. So it's circling in the cage. At last it become very tired. But the prisoner can do anything inside the cage. Okay. Prison. And some respect, the poet here is trying to depict the reality of the cage animals that are living in a very pitiable condition, losing their natural habitat. So here, what the message of the poem the author is giving? The message of the poem is, the poet is trying to depict the reality of the caged animal. How the caged, and in zoo and all we can see, there are so many animals are in the cage. So the poet was depicting the caged animal, how they are suffering inside the cage, that are living in a very pitiable means very, very sad condition, losing their natural habitat. So if it is the panther, if it is in the forest, it will enjoy their life. Okay. It will go and drink the water and he can see the nature. But here the panther was inside the cage. It like a slave and its condition is very, very pitiable. So, what is the message here? The poet here is trying to depict the reality of the caged animals that are living in a very pitiable condition, losing their natural habitat. So, here the author was debating the caged animal, not only the panther, all the caged animal are very, very pitiable. It evokes the freedom, okay, it depicts the freedom, how to release the animals. This is the meaning of the poem, very beautiful poem. So, the author, when you look at the picture, you can understand everything, okay. The panther inside the cage, how it is looking, very sad, no, inside the bar, iron bars, the panther was looking, and it as a mighty and powerful animal, he trying to come out, but he could not come out of the cage, isn't it? So, the bars are few bars only, but in panther eyes, it looks like thousands of bars, okay. And here the poet was comparing the prisoner with the animals. Animals have no sense, but a human being has sense. They can get rid of the boredom and he can do anything in the cage. But animals, they could not do anything in the cage. That is the meaning of the poem. The poem is very, very beautiful and it has deep meaning. What is the meaning? How the animals are suffering from the cage. That is the message of the poem. So, once again, I will read out the poem and you just listen. After hearing and watching the video, you should open the textbook and read the poem. They have given beautifully, given the pink letter words. You have to learn the meanings also, okay. What is the poem? His weary glance from passing by the bus has grown into a dazed and vacant stare. It seems to him there are 1,000 bars, and out behind those bars, the empty air, the pad of his strong feet, that ceaseless sound of supple tread. Behind the iron bands is like a dance of strength circling around, while in the circle stand a great will stand. But there are times the pupils of his eyes dilate, the strong limbs and stands alert and apart, tense with the flood of visions that arise only to sink and die with his art. So, who has written this poem? Rainer Maria Rilke. Okay, it's a beautiful poem. I hope you all understand this poem very well. Keep watching the videos. Don't skip any videos. Very, very important, especially grammar videos and all, you have to watch the video, okay. If you have any doubt, means you can ask me through phone. I'm ready to clarify your doubts, okay. Until then, take care. Assalamu alaikum.